My name is Doug Parker, and this is a review of Carnival Splendor. Before we get to the review, if you like this video and you'd like to see more ship tours, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. So Carnival Splendor was launched in 2007. She is the sole ship of the Splendor class and a slightly smaller version of Costa's Concordia class. She comes in at 113,300 gross registered tons, carries 3,012 guests, and is 952 feet long. In late 2019, Carnival Splendor entered a dry dock in Singapore, where she was outfitted to get ready for the Australian market. In the dry dock, she received the Alchemy Bar, the Red Frog Rum Bar, the Blue Iguana Tequila Bar, the Seafood Shack, a Red Frog Pub, and the new water slide. This video was shot a couple of days before the ship went into dry dock, so some of the spaces you'll see are pre-dry dock. We'll also put some spaces in here of the venues, what they'll actually look like. All right, so on to Carnival Splendor. Deck 1 and Deck 2 on Carnival Splendor are stateroom decks, mostly interior and ocean view rooms. There are 6 banks of elevators on Carnival Splendor. 6 of them are forward, 4 elevators midship, and 4 elevators in the very back of the ship in the aft. And then you have those glass elevators along the atrium. Those will take you from deck number 2 up to deck 11. Deck number 3 is where you'll find the ground level entrance to the main show theater. The theater is 3 levels on Carnival Splendor, found on deck 3, deck 4, and deck 5. Decent views here. Of course, deck 5 we call the cheap seats with limited views. Deck 4, decent views, but if you want a good seat, get here on the ground level on deck number 3. Outside of the theater is the guest relations desk, the shore excursions desk, and the atrium bar. You'll also find the entrance to the forward main dining room here that's called the Black Pearl Restaurant. Both of the main dining rooms on Splendor are 2 decks. They span both deck 3 and deck 4. Typically, one restaurant is used for anytime dining, while the other is used for traditional or set dining. Up to deck number 4, we'll start in the back or the very aft dining room, which is called the Gold Pearl Restaurant. This restaurant has really good views on both deck 3 and deck 4. If you want to catch a sunset while you're dining, just make sure you ask to be sat in one of these window seats. It might not hurt you to ask the maitre d' on embarkation day kind of to lock in that seat for you. As you walk outside of the main dining room on deck number 4, that's going to be the home to the new Red Frog Pub. Before the pub, this was called the Robusto Bar. This space will be more of a pub-type setting, though, with live music and cold beers on tap. A real popular place just to kind of go and have a couple of cold ones. If you keep walking forward, there's going to be a hallway between the Red Frog Pub and the midship main dining room, the one we just spoke about. And on deck number 4, you're going to be at the upper deck of the restaurant. And as you walk through the dining room and walk outside of the main dining room, you're going to come to the photo area. That's where you can buy your photos from embarkation day, your photos from formal night on the gangway, and different photos that were taken around the ship. Looking down from here, you're looking down to deck number 3 where the atrium bar is. Also a great place to stand on deck 4 and deck 5 in this spot whenever there's an atrium party happening. And keep walking forward and you'll dead end into the main theater, deck number 4, which is the mid-level section of the show theater. Up to deck number 5, starting at the back of the ship, we have the Punchliner Comedy Club. This is where all the comedy shows are held throughout the journey. Also, other things are held in here, too, because there is a little stage. So you have, like, karaoke in here, and you might find the occasional presentation, like, from a future cruise consultant on board, or someone who's trying to talk up the ports of call, or an art auction, or what have you. Leaving the aft lounge, on your port side, you're going to have the Cool Lounge. That's just another music venue. And then opposite of the Cool Lounge is going to be the Grand Piano Bar. That's going to be for your late night sing-alongs. Making your way forward from the piano bar, you're going to have the Alchemy Bar on your starboard side walking forward. And then on your port side or left side, you're going to have the nightclub here. This is where the DJ is spinning the music late into the night. Also, different theme nights here. I believe like the first night is typically like a ladies' night where they get either a dollar off their drink or a, you know, a glass of champagne as they enter there. Normally spinning until, well, depending on the crowd, about 2 a.m. or so. I've never actually seen a nightclub on a Carnival ship go past 2 a.m., but if you're into the late night scene, this is the place to be. And then the arcade is right outside. Walking forward, you're going to have the Java Blue Cafe. Before the dry dock, this space was a sushi bar, but it's going to be replaced with a coffee shop. And then just past that, on your left-hand side, is Club O2. That's the nightclub for the teenagers. The head is going to be the new cherry on top location, the fun hub where the computers are set up. And then the Royal Flush Casino. Here you're going to find your tables, your slot machines, some Texas Hold'em, blackjack, poker, those claw machines that people invest hundreds, probably thousands of dollars in per sailing, and they never win anything. But I think these claw machines are pretty rigged. I don't know. I mean, I know it is luck, but let's be honest, the odds are stacked against you. You're going to have the Ocean View Bar inside the casino here with some TVs to catch the game. And then connected to the casino is going to be a sports bar that is going to be on the port side of the ship. Now, there is no smoking allowed in the actual sports bar itself, so you can smoke in the casino, but you cannot smoke in the sports bar. Deck number 5 around the main atrium is where you'll find the fun shops on both sides of the ships. Also, a new Carnival Adventure shop being opened there post dry dock. Now, you have the glass elevators here as well that'll take you again from deck number 2 up to deck number 11. You also have your perfumes here, your jewelry, your watches, and your logo gear if you want to pick up a Carnival ship ornament or something of the sort. Also a sundry shop here as well, so if you forget like your toothpaste, deodorant, whatever, you could pick something here. And of course, the liquor shop. Yeah, a lot of people love the liquor shop and buying that duty-free booze, so you can get that here in the fun shops as well. All the way forward on deck number 5 is going to be the cheap seats. Yeah, deck number 5 of the spectacular main lounge. Yes, it's a name so nice they say it twice. At least on the deck plans they do. Spectacular. All right, deck 6, 7, and 8 are all staterooms, so you have your balcony staterooms, interiors, and ocean views on these decks. And that takes us up to deck number 9. We'll start at the back by the aft pool. For some reason, I feel like this is one of the best aft pools in the Carnival fleet. I'm not sure if it's because Splendor is in a class of its own or what, but unlike the Conquest class, which was the class of ships before this, it was covered back here. This is wide open, which really connects you with the water. You have a big pool. You have two hot tubs back here. You'll also find some Indian food, and then opposite of the Indian food is going to be the Carnival Deli, which is a little bit different because normally there's a pizza spot back here, but that's located on a different spot on Carnival Splendor. Inside the Lido Deck Buffet is where you'll find your typical buffet offerings in a newly installed seafood shack. Now, there's also two decks here, so Deck 9 and Deck 10 is part of the Lido Deck. And then walking outside towards the pool, you're going to pass the Mongolian Walk, and then, of course, Guy's Burger, which is your typical poolside burger joint on Carnival, on the starboard side. And according to the deck plans, the pizza spot is going to be on the port side. What I don't see is a Blue Iguana Cantina being installed on this ship. But the pool area is nice out here. You have one big pool, then you also have a stage and a retractable roof as well. So if there's inclement weather, you don't have to worry about, you know, not being able to go outside because you could still swim or hang out under the dome because they'll close it if it is raining on the ship. All the way forward on deck number 9 is just some staterooms and some suites up there. And then making our way up to deck number 10, that's going to be the second level of the Lido deck. So interesting concept on Carnival Splendor. There is going to be, like the newer class of ships, three tiers by the pool. There's your main Lido tier, the second tier, which is deck 10, and then the third tier, which is deck number 11. But on deck number 10 here, you have two hot tubs, one on the port side and one on the starboard side. And you keep walking back. There's a lot of open space here. It's going to take you to an overlook of the aft Lido pool. Deck number 11 is where you're going to find the Fahrenheit 555 Steakhouse. That's located on the very back of deck number 11. You can actually walk along the outside of deck number 11. That's the very third and final deck overlooking the pool. Again, the pool is on the Lido deck on deck number 9. You also have the Carnival Waterworks right here on deck number 11. And then all the way forward, you have a spa. And one thing about this ship, the spa is beautiful. First off, deck number 11 is going to be the thermal suites on the starboard side, your Oriental steam bath, your tepidarium, the waiting room, the different saunas, the Thalassal Therapy pool is up here, and then of course you have the fitness center as well on deck number 11. Also on this ship, the men and ladies changing rooms have their own sauna in there as well, so if you want to get into the sauna and you don't feel like spending the money on a spa pass, you could hop into the complimentary sauna in the changing room on deck number 11 within the respective locker room. Deck number 12 forward, you have the second deck of the spa, your flotation therapy, your mild treatments, your VIP spa suites are up here in your relaxation room. And then you have the Serenity located on the outside with the topside bar. Mostly you'll just find a lot of day beds up here. And then going back to deck number 12 aft, you're going to have the sports deck. That's where you're going to have the basketball court, the jogging track. And the jogging track is nice because it's just underneath the funnel. So if you want to get some spectacular views of sunrise or sunset, come up here to deck number 12 aft on the sun deck and you can get some amazing shots. And then deck number 14 is the sky deck, and that's where the mini golf course is located all the way forward, as well as your slide entrance to the Carnival Waterworks Park. And that'll do it for our tour of Carnival Splendor. If you like this video and you'd like to see more content, subscribe to the channel and give the video a thumbs up. You're the reason why I do make these videos. My name is Doug Parker. I'm the host of Cruise Radio and the daily Cruise Radio News Briefs. You can find both of those where you listen to your favorite podcast. Just search Cruise Radio or Cruise Radio News. So what do you think about Carnival Splendor? Have you sailed her in the past, or are you planning on sailing her in the future? Let me know what you thought of this ship. She was actually originally designed for another cruise line, and then halfway through construction, she got transferred to Carnival Cruise Line. That's why the spa is so massive on this ship. But I want to know your thoughts, so let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching.